He had Sion in there, he had the whole thing in there.
Of course, yeah.
And for instance, when Neo had decided that he wanted to know the truth, and he was no longer wanting to be kept in this illusion, and Morpheus offered him the blue or the red pill, and he took the one to see the truth, obviously. When he woke up, there's a little robot that came up, a machine that came up and looked at him. And then the machine just looked at him and then shot off, right? And you think to yourself, why didn't that machine attack him? And the reason why that machine didn't attack him is because Neo in the film basically had seen through everything. He knew the truth and no longer could provide energy for the machines in that pod. Basically, I've got this kind of feeling that as we're approaching 2012, we're obviously approaching some kind of new cosmological energy of some sort. Something involving the universe, which we're probably far too great for any of us to really comprehend at the moment. But working on the mind before matter, like idea. Basically, I envisage what's going on as we're moving closer to this date and we're getting closer to this energy all the time. Manifestation time between kind of, thoughts and manifestation creating themselves into matter is getting shorter.
Because we are being drawn toward the attractor through shorter and shorter epochs. And not only must the entire last 4,000 years of history be compressed into this 67-year period from 1945 to 2012, but there is a 384-day period preceding December 22nd, 2012, when the last 67 years and the last 4,300 years have to be compressed into that. Then there's a final 6-day period when all of these things are compressed again. And so do you see what's happening? The spiral is tightening as it goes faster and faster. The resonances are impinging. The thing is getting nuttier and nuttier and nuttier as computers link all cultures together, all informational barriers dissolve. Everything is becoming connected to everything else. Not only everything in the present moment, but all past moments as well are being drawn, compressed, squeezed toward the production of the transcendental object at the end of time, which is nothing less than all time, all space, shrunk down to an atomic dimension and handed back to us.
Do you understand what I'm saying? The spirit, the gap between consciousness and our material bodies are closing up, and so eventually we'll be able to create our reality a lot quicker than we currently do. If you look at what's going on, for instance, in Indiana Jones, the symbology all over that film for 2012, there's the Mayan calendar. They don't acknowledge it, but he's rocking on the Mayan calendar in that film. There's loads of other stuff that coincide with the Mayan prophecies and stuff. And the same goes is like when I was on my trip down to Paris the other week, and I was driving down the M1 in Britain, and the first motorway service station I got to, I walked to the shop, and I went in there, and there's this big pile of books on offer, and the books that they sell in motorway service stations are terrible. They never give you any knowledge whatsoever, not good for anything, but there's this one book on offer, and I went over to it, and it was a book all about the end of the world in 2012 on the main motorway of like Britain's motorway in one of the shops, one of the main shops that you get on the service stations. And I've got this feeling that what's going on as we're getting close to this energy, and as we're getting this gap between kind of thought and manifestation of matter is getting shorter, there's a particular force out there that's trying to implicate that 2012 is going to be a huge disaster. And for instance, next year, the man who released Stargate and Independence Day is releasing the film 2012.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And it's going to be the biggest disaster movie on record, going for $200 million.
You know,
there's plenty of starving people in the world, but we can spend $200 million on this film.
Oh, of course, no problem. Sheesh.
And what this film is going to perpetrate, and everyone on the bloody planet is going to know about 2012 for being a disaster. So if what I'm saying is this idea of a mind before matter situation, if the general population are all believing that 2012 is going to come around and it's going to be a disaster, our consciousness could end up manifesting that for us. And the problem we've got is obviously that the people in power have the technological, the technology to survive such a thing, and the general population don't. So it's all about the manifestation of a disaster that they're trying to swing their way by putting out this information to the public.
One,
do you understand what I'm saying?
Of course. One quick question there is, if they're at the same time are trying to put, Prince William up as the new messiah, if you will.
Yeah.
Are they at the same time also trying to destroy everything that they are building up here then around 2012?
Well, the interpretation I've got is that in between this 2008 and 2012, because obviously the two logos contain the word Zion,
there's
going to be a lot of things happening between those 4 years. We're not just going to end up with one event. It's going to be a sequence of events continually.
Yeah.
And I believe for anyone to be implemented as king of the world, which I think they're aiming for, you're going to have to touch, you're going to have to touch people, and those people are going to be, they're going to have been stretched. Do you know what I mean? They're going to have to be on an emotional knife edge to believe everything that they're seeing.
Yeah.
That's all I can say, is that I do believe that in the run-up, for instance, when you've got Prince Charles beaming himself into the EU via holographic technology.
Yeah, there we go.
And stating stuff along the lines of that he knows for a fact that in 18 months' time we're going to have a sequence of mega disasters all around the world. How does that man know that that is going to happen?
Did he say that?
Yeah, he did say it. What? He said it about 2 weeks ago.
Really? No.
Yeah, do a search for Prince Charles, natural disasters, 18 months, and you'll probably find it straight away.
Okay, I will do that. That's very interesting. Okay.
But how does this man know that? Do you know what I mean? It's scary.
Well, he's at the potentially at the top of the pyramid, you know? Who knows?
He's Osiris, isn't he?
Well, exactly. There you go. Exactly. He is. this is... there's so many people also that have been looking at Prince William and that come from this from a different angle and so forth. I definitely see that there's something there. I mean, there's incredible stuff going on the symbolical level. And yet I always try to, or rather I kind of move back towards the other perspective of is this something, is there an archetypal image within civilization of man that right now always kind of strive for the Trinity, and whatever people that are in a position to represent this Trinity are going to be put forth as such, and those who are smart enough to pick up on this can see it? Or is this a totally manipulated thing from day one, going in, this is what we're going to do, and this is where everything leads? What do you think about that?
As far as I'm concerned, we never really chose our royal family. So as far as people pushing these forwards as these archetypes, I don't see that, because they seem to have claimed this land without any real justification.
Yeah, of course.
So I perceive this as something that's being hijacked.
You know what?
I mean, obviously, all of this could be at the very least just my creative brain coming up with a brilliant story.
I agree with you on one level. I always keep the other door open, but that doesn't mean that I reject either one of the theories. You know, I'm totally forward with what you're saying here. I mean, I totally agree. It's incredible when you think about it. You know what? I want to do like this. I want to give you a proposition here, so to speak. I want to have you back on the program, and because we actually have gone through basically 2 hours now, I think that this is a good amount of information for this time. So what do you say, Rik? Are we up for a part two here in a while?
Yeah, that's fine. No worries. I'm up for that.
Okay, great. Because there's so much more to talk about. But okay, let's begin to round things up here, because this has been very interesting, and I think that what you managed to do here also in a way is to kind of take a lot of the material that is out there. You know, there's basically, this is the big, the grand, you know,